Daddy.
Spall us their hands up.
Hola,
que tuvo la tuvada de Yarishwa.
Russia, Zakhmede, Russia, Russia. Mudded worker, Russia.
You seem to have had a spot of trouble, Captain King.
Oh?
Lieutenant Heath, the Bashar garrison.
Oh, Mr. Heath.
I've come to escort you in, sir.
Khadekana! I'm certainly glad you arrived when you did, Mr. Heath.
Yes, so am I. General Maitland will be looking for those supplies.
Tiara! Corporal,
sir?
Bring the Afridi here.
Yes, sir. You took a prisoner, sir?
No, he came down out of the hills and warned us of the attack.
You had beginner's luck, if you don't mind my saying so, sir. He might have been leading you into an ambush instead of out of one. Sort of thing you'll learn to expect from the natives when you've been here for a while.
What about the natives in British uniform, Mr. Heath?
They're just better dressed, sir. Between ourselves, the native doesn't change color when he joins up. They're all brothers under the skin.
I'll try to remember that, Mr. Heath.
Excuse me, sir. Here he is.
Oh. You saved our lives. We're very grateful. What is your name?
We'll get downwind.
Muridi Para Shikrana.
Come on.
Stanum today.
Ahmed Khan. Zahdi Karam Khan Ladashkarna. Takdi Deliyam. Karam Khan Disraide. Chita Subandi Halakawa.
He says his name is Ahmed. He deserted from the force that attacked us. A force led by a fanatic named Kurum Khan.
Looks like Kurum Khan's handiwork, all right. That blight has been playing hob with us lately. He operates from a place called Jatri at the top of the Khyber Pass. Devilish hard to get at. We tried twice, didn't get as far as the front door.
Mung Sararasha.
Khuda.
He'll accompany us to the garrison.
Anchiwa!
Anchiwa!
I say, you handle their lingo very well, sir. You've served on this frontier before?
No, Mr. Heath. I haven't. Would you mind giving us a hand?
Oh, no, of course not.
The general is very angry.
Lolly, it's much too hot for a lecture.
Better a lecture than a burial.
Paul Singh, see that he's rubbed down and give him a double ration of oats. He's earned it.
Sergeant, bring on the column.
Detail with guides for the column, sir. The general wishes to see you.
I have three casualties, one stretcher case.
We'll take care of them, sir. The headquarters is over there, sir.
Thank you. Ahmed, Master Arasha.
Good on.
It's my belief, sir, that this action will not be confined to the hill tribes alone. In Peshawar, the mullahs are already arousing the people. Ahmed says they plan to attack on what they call the Night of the Long Knives.
Mullahs? If they're in it, it means a holy war.
That's right, sir. Why has he brought us this information?
What I brought call you?
Gusti hefty po. Karam country bed bavalo de para. Durur mi jaba wushu kula suruti bazarja stuli shodi. Alad minam bendi. Ron rami sarapa kaiber rifle. Khil jamakad al guram. Nimakhil al bayan.
A week ago, his brother spoke against Karam Khan. His tongue was torn out and the skin was peeled from his body. On behalf of his brother, Ahmed would like to eat the British salt and join his cousins in the Khyber Rifles. Mr. White.
Sir?
See that he's passed through intelligence and sworn in.
Ashastan Balaiman.
Shukran, Ahmed Mirka.
We've been hearing a lot of these rumors lately, Captain King. You came through Delhi. Any talk there of a Night of the Long Knives?
Well, sir, there's talk of unrest all over India. But nothing as definite as what Ahmed has told us.
Mr. Heath.
Sir.
You'll arrange quarters for Captain King.
Well, there's room in my bungalow, sir. Just Mr. Baird and myself since Captain Walsh was killed.
That's all, gentlemen. Thank you, gentlemen.
The stout fellow, Walsh. I wonder if you ever knew him.
Good news from headquarters for a change. They've developed a new rifle, the Enfield. Twice the range of anything we've seen. We'll have a shipment next month.
There's any truth in Captain King's report. The sooner they get here, the better. By the way, Ian, anything about Captain King strike you as rather odd?
Odd? No, sir. Except that he's right at home with the Pashto language. It's more than I can say for myself after all these years.
Let me see that record of service.
When birds do spring in springtime...
Pankawala! Wake up, you lazy heathen! If I catch you sleeping again, you'll go begging for your wages. You sure you won't have one on that?
No, thank you.
It's a long, dusty road to Peshawar.
Well, that makes one feel better for a while.
Drink, Ben?
Rather. Thanks, old boy. Now, don't drown it. Water's for the outside of the body.
It looks fine, Napoor.
Thank you, Captain Sahib. Which reminds me, Captain King. Now that you've joined us, we'll have to rearrange the bathing times. It takes at least three a day in this stinking climate.
I'm sure we'll make out somehow, Mr. Baird.
What is the big attraction in Peshawar, eh?
Couldn't be some Norch dancer.
Well, this particular notch dancer happens to be an old man of 70. He brought me up after my parents died. Thank you.
Oh, then you have been in this part of the world before?
I was born here.
Oh, so that's it. You had me on the go for a while. Did you hear that, Ben? We're rooming with the early natives.
Salam, Captain Sahib.
Oh, by the way, back before sundown. The shower's out of bounds after dark.
Well, there's plenty of time.
Phew, I say. May I?
Sure.
Look at this bed. It's a bit of all right. Your father?
Yes. Major in the 3rd Lancers. He was killed here on this garrison in the rebellion of 33.
Yes, I understand that was pretty rugged.
My mother.
Yes, well, she's a beautiful woman.
Thank you. Muslim women are often beautiful. Gentlemen?
Welcome, Captain Saab.
Good day.
If the Captain Saab is here because he has heard certain rumors concerning my establishment, I assure him they are lies spread by my enemies. As the Saab can see, it is merely a place of comfort for the weary traveler.
No, I'm seeking news of Hamid Barra, who lived here at one time.
Hamid Barra?
The silk merchant. He lived here with his son, Hassan.
That was many years ago, Captain Saab.
What has happened to him? Is he alive?
Men like Hamid Barra do not die easily.
Where is he to be found?
There's no secret where one looks for a priest of the true faith.
He's become a holy man?
Each man must choose his own path, Captain Saab. You'll find him at the mosque on the hill behind the bazaar.
Thank you.
Captain Saab, why are you here? So quiet.
Please pick a mystery.
What did he say?
He talks of a prophecy. 100 years the British had in India, no more. And this is the 100th year.
Soon the night of the long knives will come to India. Death will be called down on every infidel, as he calls down the birds from the skies.
How does he do it?
Who knows? I've seen mullahs change the minds of men. Why not the wings of a bird?
You have no business here. There may be trouble. Where do you live?
The garrison side.
Then get back there as quick as you can. Do as I say.
Well,
Find the man you were looking for?
Yes. Yes, thanks.
Good. Like a drink?
Aren't you being rather generous with Mr. Heath's bottle?
Oh, he left it. Say when.
Left it?
Sort of a farewell offering. He moved in with a couple of polo chums. You know, team spirit, shop talk, all that sort of thing. Anyway, it simplifies the bathing problem.
I appreciate the gesture, Mr. Baird. But you don't have to stay.
Well, I'd rather, if you don't mind. After all, we half-cars ought to stick together. Didn't you know? My mother's Irish.
It started out as a simple shopping expedition. And it turned into the most exciting afternoon I've ever known. Very Indian. Very sinister. Here you are, Jeffrey.
Well, go on. Don't keep me dangling. What happened?
Well, there we were, surrounded by a large crowd of unfriendly faces. A wild-eyed mullah promising death to every infidel. Birds coming down out of the sky. They're telling what might have happened if Captain King hadn't come along.
King?
Yes. It was amazing, really. The way he talked to them. The way they listened.
I shouldn't wonder.
Why do you say that, Jeffrey?
Well, he's one of them.
A native?
Near enough. He's a Chichi. Born right here in Peshawar. Mother was a Muslim.
I knew there was something different about him.
I don't blame him for being surprised. Fella took me in until I saw the family portrait. Not a bad look, I, my dad.
Good evening.
Good evening, Father.
Good evening, sir.
Do I have to die of thirst, Susan?
Of course not, Father.
I understand you moved out of your bungalow today, Mr. Heath.
Yes, I did.
Not comfortable?
No, sir.
You haven't complained about your quarters during the past year?
Until today, I had no cause for complaint, if you know what I mean, sir.
Yes, I believe I do.
Didn't think you'd mind, sir.
Here you are, Father.
Thank you, my dear. It so happens, Mr. Heath, I do mind. In future, you'll remember that on this garrison, whites, half-caste, and natives are all British soldiers and will be treated as such.
I understand, sir.
General Sahib, Captain King.
Good evening, King.
General Maitland. Miss Maitland.
Good evening, Captain. You know Mr. Heath.
Of course. Good evening, Mr. Heath.
Good evening.
I'll fix you a drink.
Thank you.
I'm glad you could come.
It was good of you to ask me, sir.
Susan told me about the run-in this afternoon. Thanks for lending a hand.
You see, Captain, I like to pay my debts as quickly as possible.
Miss Sahib, do not disturb.
You're seated on my right, Captain. Bring your drinks.
Come along, Heath. I don't suppose you know much about an outfit called the Khyber Rifles, do you, King?
No, sir. But Ahmed, the Afridi who warned us, spoke of them as cousins. I assume they must be Afridis.
That's right. They're volunteers from the hills, mountain fighters. Not much love lost between them and Kurram Khan. Most of them have personal grievances like Ahmed's. Families tortured, villages burned, that sort of thing.
Well, if they're all like Ahmed, they should give a good account of themselves.
I'm glad you think so. Since it'll be your job to see that they do, I'm putting you in command.
Oh, thank you, sir.
And you may not thank me after your first day with them. They're rather a picturesque lot, wouldn't you say, Mr. Heath?
I couldn't have put it better, sir.
Your Khyber Rifles are fierce and proud, with a complete indifference to discipline. Matter of fact, we haven't been able to get them to salute. They're convinced it's undignified. They also have an irritating habit of taking off whenever the mood strikes them. Last week it struck their sergeant.
You might have just deserted.
I suppose so, according to the manual. Then the Khyber Rifles can't read the manual.
Captain King, I must apologize for my father. He has a habit of turning every social occasion into a meeting of the general staff.
You're absolutely right, Susan. Your turn.
I understand you were born in Peshawar, Captain.
Yes, that's right. I lived there until I was 12.
Needless to say, I'm glad you came home on this particular day. I suppose this afternoon you're in the city to look up old friends.
I visited a man who took me into his home after my parents were killed. He brought me up with his own son, a boy named Hassan.
Must have been a touching reunion after all those years.
I saw only the father. The son was in the hills. He's better known to you by the name of Kurram Khan.
Did you know that the son of your old friend was Kurram Khan? I mean, before you were assigned to this post?
No, sir, I did not.
Awkward situation. If you prefer, I could have you assigned to some less personal frontier.
That's up to you, sir.
No, Captain King, it's up to you.
I'd rather stay here, sir.
Then you'll take over the Khyber Rifles.
Thank you, sir.
Shall we take a coffee on the veranda? Such a lovely evening.
Good idea, Susan.
General Maitland, might I be excused, sir? It's been a rather long day.
Of course.
Thank you, sir. Miss Maitland?
Good night, Captain.
Mr. Heath? Good night, sir.
Good man. He has a bit of a problem, too. It's not easy, you know, riding two horses.
No, it's not. But he sits them both quite well. Oh, Captain King. Congratulations. It seems you have a rare gift for handling men.
Thank you.
What a pity you don't understand women that well.
They weren't part of the course at Sandhurst.
That must explain why we haven't seen you since you had dinner with us. Frankly, I've done everything in my power to make you aware of me, but you haven't even blinked. However, I shall take care of that. I put you down for two dances at the Queen's birthday ball.
Tonight? Well, I don't believe...
There's simply no point in arguing, Captain. On the night of the Queen's birthday, we must observe tradition.
Tradition will be observed, Miss Maitland. I promise you.
Good. Until tonight, then?
Good afternoon, Miss Maitland.
Dance like an angel.
Thank you, Jeffrey.
It's much cooler on the veranda, and I've arranged for a move.
Next one's ours, I believe, my dear.
Yes, Father.
The commissioner has another attack of gout, Mr. Heath. His wife wishes to dance. She's over there under the potted plant.
Whatever you say, sir.
Shall we try the great experiment? You look very handsome tonight, Susan.
It's mostly the dress, Father, but thank you. Father?
Step on your toes again?
Captain King was invited tonight, wasn't he?
As a matter of fact, no, he wasn't.
Why not?
Rather difficult to explain.
Was it because of his mother?
your manner of speaking, yes.
You know, he's allowed to die for the Queen, but her birthday party's out of bounds.
Now, Susan.
Excuse me, Father.
Where are you going?
It's a bit stuffy in here.
Susan.
That dressing gown you gave Lieutenant Heath. You didn't really mean a word of it, did you?
On the contrary.
Do you expect me to believe that after tonight?
Tonight was altogether out of my hands.
You are the commander here.
Officially, yes, but I don't make the rules of the officers' club. I can't break them. I merely belong.
I think it's stupid and hateful.
Let's just say that it's wrong. This is India and things don't change overnight. All I can do is to try to set the others an example. Do I have to remind you that he's already had dinner at my house?
I'm sorry, Father. I should have known that you were all people. Forgive me.
Excuse me, sir. The commissioner would like to see you.
Thank you, Mr. Baird. Excuse me, Susan.
Could a lieutenant hope to fill in for the general man?
Thank you, Mr. Baird. But I'll tell you a secret. Feet are killing me.
I'm sorry.
Good evening.
I know this is against regulations, but please don't tell me I shouldn't be here.
All right, I won't.
I found out what you meant this afternoon about tradition being observed. Smut superiority. It makes me ashamed of my own blood.
I'm afraid you find it rather tiring carrying a cross, Miss Maitland, especially in this heat.
Are you making fun of me, Captain?
No. I'm an old hand carrying crosses, and I put mine away some time ago. I've been much more comfortable ever since.
I seem to have made a fool of myself.
No, please. I'm very grateful.
Don't you mind when people behave the way they do?
I mind. But I hope for the best. The world's still young. They've started again.
Yes, they have.
Your partner will be looking for you.
Unfortunately, my partner for this one wasn't invited. Number 6. You do dance, don't you, Captain?
On occasion.
Isn't the Queen's birthday an occasion? I really ought to go now. Number 7's with Major McAllister.
Wouldn't do to keep the Major waiting.
No, I suppose not. Thank you.
Good night.
I've never enjoyed a Queen's birthday ball so much. Good night.
Curson with dispatches, sir.
Good morning, Miss Curson.
Dispatch from Calcutta to deliver to you personally, sir.
Thank you. Good trip?
No incident, sir.
Mr. White, you'll arrange quarters for Mr. Curson. And send in Major McAllister.
Very good.
Thank you. Michael Waller. Banjo.
You sent for me, sir?
Yes.
The Viscount's on its way from the Dom Dom Arsenal with 600 of the new Enfields. That's more like it.
Should be here within the week.
Tunkawala! Give us a chunk of air here! Fried. That's what it says in a man's service record. Fried for God and Queen.
Maitland, I thought it was against orders for women to ride off garrison without an escort.
That's why I've joined you. You might as well understand, Captain. There's absolutely no way you can avoid me. Give up?
Kenusta la Tubara.
Longer a room for a small boy, would you say?
I assume it was furnished differently. How did you come to live here?
Hamid Barrow was my mother's only friend, and my father's. Shukran.
Hadn't you any grandparents?
When my father married a Muslim, his parents disowned him. My mother's family mourned her for dead. When they were killed in the rebellion, there was no door open to me, but this one.
Your mother and father must have been very much in love. Stand together against the world.
Come, sir, inquire, Sahib.
I'm sorry, you have a holiday.
There, Hada.
Said to follow certain travelers. The first was a herder from Jatra named Masafir. It may strike before we can reach the garrison.
Had we better turn back to Peshawar?
No, there isn't time. We'll take shelter in the ruins of the Temple of Bilitis there. Come on.
Thank you. strange. What a weird sound. It's actually chilly.
Some say this is the tomb of Asaphar the herder. Others say that he was struck by the hammer of God, taken up in the clouds. But he's still there. It happened centuries ago. When I was a boy, I was brought here by Hamid Bara. He showed me where the old priest sat. One so wise that he could imagine a stick with only one end. I saw a field where, because the blood of sacred cattle had been spilled, nothing would grow except some berry trees. But no man could eat the fruit, because it would not leave the body but stay to stain the soul.
Go on. Please don't stop. I felt that I was with you when you were a boy.
Field rations and water for an extended patrol. Yes, Captain?
Officer of the week reporting, sir.
Besides my daughter, is anyone else missing?
Yes, sir. Captain King. He had leave to proceed to Peshawar and has not returned.
Very good, thank you.
Mr. Heath?
Sir?
Your patrol will search the desert between here and Peshawar.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Baird?
Sir?
You and your patrol will go toward the Khyber.
Yes, sir.
One shot from the cannon will be the signal to return.
Right, sir.
Thank you, gentlemen, and good luck.
Off section, left!
Off section, left! Spot!
They'll do everything possible, Jonathan. Besides, Captain King is not the average officer. He's a... Well, he's very capable.
Thank you.
garrison.
I hope she sleeps the clock around. That's the best cure there is.
Thank you, Major Lee.
Well, Captain King, have the other patrols returned yet?
All except Lieutenant Baird, sir.
Those men who rode up on you, how many were there?
Four, sir.
What makes you think they were from Kurram Khan? Did they say so?
No, sir.
Stand easy.
The fact that they wanted your daughter as a hostage led me to believe.
I suppose there's no doubt of it. If he failed once, it doesn't mean that he won't try again. Wouldn't that be your guess?
He might, sir.
In that case, the answer would be to remove the potential hostage, don't you think?
That would be one answer, sir.
I'm sure there'll be no opposition from Susan. She's been after me for some time to send her home to England. Never been happy here. I stuck it out for my sake. She's been bored and restless. You know what can happen to someone in that frame of mind? The desire for danger. Anything different to make the days go by? Normally, she's a very level-headed person, but... Any of this make any sense to you?
I think so, sir.
Well, she's already had a couple of narrow escapes. No point in pressing our luck. I think it best to send her home to England before she becomes involved in... things Indian, shall we say. Naturally, I'll miss her. And that's a small sacrifice when your daughter's entire life is at stake.
I believe I know how you feel, sir.
Thank you, King. I shouldn't have burdened you with my personal problems, but I had to talk to someone about it.
May I go now, sir?
Of course. Very inconsiderate of me. I know today's been an ordeal for you as well. Thank you, King.
She woke up hungry, General Saab. A good sign.
Feeling well enough for a visitor?
Come on in, Father. I've had enough sleep for a month. I seem to be a constant source of worry to you. I really deserve a scolding.
Susan. While they were out looking for you, I had a lot of time to think. I made myself a promise.
What sort of promise?
That if you got back safely, I'd send you home to England. I'll miss you very much, of course.
It's very sweet of you, Father. But you can't get rid of me as easily as that.
Can't I? Already made the arrangements.
Then you simply have to unmake them. I'm not going.
A month ago, it was all you could think of.
A month ago, I didn't know I was going to marry Captain King.
Marry? Captain King. You mean he's asked you?
No. But he will. In time.
You realize what this means, don't you? Surely you can't be serious.
But I am. You do approve of Captain King, don't you?
Oh, Susan, this is no time to be thinking of marriage.
You haven't answered my question.
Your life has been threatened. I intend to see that it doesn't happen again.
No. That's not the reason at all, is it?
Susan.
It's no use, Father. We've never been able to lie to each other.
You can't marry him, Susan.
Say what you're thinking, Father.
All right. He's a half-caste.
I thought that made no difference to you.
It doesn't, except...
Except when it touches you.
It's one thing to be broad-minded, another one... Susan, that's how the world is. I can't change it. I know what your life would be. I don't want you to get hurt. I'm only thinking of your happiness.
Isn't that what people always say when they intend to make you unhappy? I'm sorry for you, Father. Please go away. Please go away.
Corporal Stewart, sir. The lady's dead, sir.
Mr. Baird and his searching party were taken hostage. Khurram Khan has learned that we're expecting a shipment of Enfield rifles. Unless I agree to hand them over to him as soon as they arrive, he'll send back one man a day in the same condition as Corporal Stewart. Of course, you realize, gentlemen, we must disregard his threat. Mr. Heath?
Sir.
You'll take a squadron and intercept the supply column here, Malalapur. Obtain camels at the depot and transfer the rifles to camel loads. The supply column will proceed with the empty rifle boxes by the usual route. You will detour through the Malakund Hills for the camel train. Any questions?
No, sir.
That's all, gentlemen.
May I have a word with you, sir?
Yes, King? What is it?
You remember what Ahmed said? That the hill tribes would fight together only under Khurram Khan.
Well?
Well, I was thinking, sir, that there might not be an uprising at all if Khurram Khan were dead.
That's possible. He happens to be very much alive.
He's mortal, sir. If a man could get close enough, a man with special qualifications.
You realize that even if you were successful, which I doubt, you'd never leave Jatri alive.
I'm aware of that possibility, sir.
I'm sorry, Captain King. In the present emergency, we'll need every officer we have. You'll remain with your command.
Yes, sir.
Alan.
Did anyone see you come in here?
Oh, Alan, I don't know, and it makes no difference.
But it does make a difference, a very great difference.
I had to talk to you.
But now, at this hour, here, like this?
Yes, now. Please, Alan. Father's sending me away.
That's probably the most sensible thing for him to do. He's worried about your safety. We all are. I didn't tell you, but yesterday at the temple, those four Afridis were demanding you as a hostage.
Well, I won't be sent away. Not like this. Not until I've said all the things we've left unsaid. I love you, Alan. I love you very much. Now, wait. You'll listen to me now. You wouldn't listen to me when you held me in your arms and we danced. You wouldn't listen when that man was singing to us yesterday. You won't even listen to your own heart. But you will hear me now. You must.
But it just wouldn't work. It couldn't.
Why not? Why not? Are we going to admit that we have less courage than your father and mother? Wasn't the love they had for each other big enough to make up for everything? Are we going to deny ourselves the happiness that was theirs and can be ours because of a situation born of mistrust and hatred between strangers? Do they really know or care what happens to us?
Susan.
Oh, if you only knew how I've longed to hear my name on your lips. Hold me in your arms, Alan. And tell me just once what we both know to be true.
Being close to you, seeing you every day. I do love you. Everything you said was right. But this is not the time. You must go away. Not only from here now, but away from the garrison, away from India.
I don't want to. But I can now. Goodbye, Alan. I want you to know that no matter where my father sends me, I will come to you. I will come to you and I will be with you always. When you want me.
Together for some 15 years. I value your opinion, you know that. I'd like it now.
Of course, Donovan.
You agree that our situation would be greatly improved if Kurram Khan were killed?
There's no doubt about that, but...
There's a possibility it can be done by one of our officers.
Oh?
It means almost certain death, I'm afraid. But it's a question of one man's life against the safety of the garrison. That, after all, must be my first consideration.
Jonathan, you don't have to justify a decision like that to me.
Major McAllister, I expect support from my officers, not sympathy.
Yes, sir. Whom are you sending, sir?
The only man on the garrison who knows Kurram Khan.
Oh, I see.
Sir, Captain King is not in the garrison.
Huh?
He was observed 2 hours ago by an outlying sentry, proceeding alone in the direction of the Khyber Pass. Thank you, Mr. White.
our general has agreed to our terms about the rifles?
I come here on a different mission. I wish to speak to Kurram Khan.
He is in council. You may tell me what you have to say.
I will speak only to him.
Here we curb a man's insolence by removing his tongue.
I am a friend of Kurram Khan's.
Hagata Paswani Okarai.
Hamza. Dasare Stadoste Kanha.
It's been many years, Hassan.
Alan, I never thought to see my brother again, except in battle. Why have you come here?
I have deserted.
Very commendable, but why?
In their world, I am despised for the blood that runs in my veins, the blood we share. I could no longer endure their insults.
The British have an odd way of showing their contempt.
My self-respect is worth more to me than a few scraps of metal.
I knew it would come one day. And when it did, where should you turn but to your boyhood friend?
You have learned many things, Hassan.
One thing, Alan. It has happened in the past that a British soldier has gone over to the enemy and continued to serve the British. His protection is to call himself a deserter.
My word, Hassan. I was not sent here.
In the boy is the shadow of the man. Your word was always good, Alan.
I asked to serve you.
You have already done so. A British deserter, perhaps the first of many. Think how proud it will make my future allies. Iqbal Hussein, Satta Shah, Muhammad Abda, Waza Ali, Mustafa Akbar. To serve with a soldier of the Queen. See that my brother is given clothing and everything he requires. And remember, he is my brother.
Khan Sahib. The Khan Sahib brought out Freda Jabba.
We will talk later, Alan. I'll want to know many things. Watch him. The British love their games. We find ourselves allies. Well, it's a short road that has no turn. We were not always such friends, you and I. Tell me something, Alan. Was it you who let my spotted snake escape?
Only after you fed him my collection of birds' eggs.
Ah, your precious birds' eggs. And then later, when we played our game of war, and you defended Pasha against my onslaughts, we were true enemies then, remember?
I remember mostly that I was never victorious.
Victorious against Kurram Khan? That would have changed history.
I nearly did once. I had my wooden sword at your throat.
Ah, but I pointed to a crow in the sky, and as you looked, I tumbled you into the fountain.
For which your father took away your sword.
I'm told you saw my father.
Yes.
My noble father. I offered to share all of India with him. Instead, he took a knife to his wrist. I leave old men to their prayers, Alan. Life is for the young. When the hour is called, the people will plunder and butcher and burn. The fools will lay waste to their own cities.
It is what they leave of India that I shall build a new one. An empire for Karim Khan.
You heard what he said, Adam?
Yes.
Did you know the wagons were empty? The camels were carrying the new Enfield rifles for the Malakand Hills?
Evidently, General Maitland has learned to respect your genius.
Our loss will not be General Maitland's gain. Those rifles will never be used against us.
Delta Russia. F. Saravastua.
Get out! Get out!
Why you came here. You arrived with a story a sheep boy would not believe. I want the real reason. I offered to come here to kill you. And would have. But something happened at the garrison which made it clear that I could no longer stay there. I could no longer continue as a British officer.
Tell me about her. The one with the white skin.
She had nothing to do with it.
Still a little British in you, isn't there?
Yes, she had a lot to do with it. The general found out and told you he didn't want you.
You could die for the British, but you couldn't live with them. Do you love her?
Yes.
Well, never mind. After I've taken India, you can have her. And all you want, like her. Danino, Rovasto. Alan here is one of your friends. He could marry her and live in the garrison. He has the right kind of blood in his veins.
Captain King, please, please tell me.
Yes, sir. I begin to believe you. Yes, I do believe you. You were my brother once. You are my brother now. We have many roads to travel. We will cast our shadows upon them together.
Congratulations, Adam. You took me in completely. The knife will no longer be of use to you. There was a moment when you could have used it and didn't. If I hadn't awakened, would you have killed me?
Yes.
But for a split second, the past held you back. That is the difference, Alan, between a great man and just a man. Split second.
How many men could have ruled the world but for that split second when they hesitated and destiny passed them by?
Delta Rashad.
Like my father, Alan, you're a victim of your conscience. There are many like him. That is why I cannot fail. Nor a Bandine to Arbiter.
Rock it off.
You see, Alan, even I am not wholly without a conscience. Last night you spared my life. Now I return the gesture. You will be returned safely to Peshawar. But we'll meet again. And when we do, there will be no hesitation. I will cut you out of my path as I would a weed. The scales are balanced now. There is no past.
You say Lieutenant Baird, Privates Jenkins, Sibley, and Burnett were killed right in front of you.
Yes, sir. Pick glanced.
I see. And you'd like me to understand that your disappearance from the garrison was connected with your offer to kill Kurram Khan?
Yes, sir, it was.
Well?
He's still alive, sir. I had an opportunity to kill him, but I have no explanations.
How did you manage to escape from Jatra, Captain King?
I didn't escape, sir. Kurram Khan gave me safe escort.
In return for his life?
Yes, sir.
Have you anything further to say?
There was a council of tribal leaders when I was in Jatra, sir. Not only the Afridi that Ahmed told us about, but the Wazir and Bungish as well. They're about ready to join forces, sir. It would mean a total of roughly 5,000 men.
Led by the man whose life you spared.
There's something else, sir. Kurram Khan says that the Enfields will never be used against him.
He was mistaken. The Khyber Rifles have been using them ever since the day they arrived.
The excellent weapon, I might add.
Mr. Heath.
Sir?
Conduct Captain King to his quarters under close arrest.
Yes, sir.
What are you making?
What can I believe?
is wrong about the Enfields?
Would you have to court martial?
Is there an alternative?
Last of the women's things. Bird cages and the like. There'd be a ready bunch of junk by the time they get to Simla.
Simla?
Yes, women were ordered there by forced march. Headquarters thought it might be getting a bit too hot for them here.
All the women?
Yes, the whole lot. They left this morning. Oh, by the way, if you're concerned about Susan, she asked me to give you a message. She'll write to you from Simla. Said that nothing had changed. She still feels the same way.
Thank you, Mr. Heath.
Not at all.
Mr. Burke, sir.
Dispatch from Delhi, sir. 10 of us will day and night.
Thank you, Mr. Burke. You speak to Mr. Weiss, he'll arrange quarters for you.
Yes, sir.
Mutiny in Meerut Garrison. Civil uprising throughout Bengal. Rioting in Delhi. Take immediate security measures. It's happened.
The night of the long knives.
This must be the moment Kurram Khan's been waiting for. Mutiny on the whole frontier. If it spreads this far, we're fair game for our friends in the hills. Order every unit commander on the garrison to report here immediately.
Everyone, sir?
Yes, Major, including Captain King.
Yes, sir. Psst. Psst. I'm in. Russia. Plus. Bhakti. Istimal Makawa.
Ready?
Last pa kartus na bakte.
Captain Sahib.
Our position is clear. Every city on the frontier is facing an uprising. If Kurram Khan comes down out of the hills, it's no position at all. And I have a report that he's uniting all the hill tribes. When that happens, we can't defend against him down here.
Sir, are you suggesting that we bring the attack to him?
Captain King.
Sir.
You know the terrain? Is it possible?
Not through the pass, sir. Behind his camp is a solid circle of cliffs. Under cover of night, a company of trained mountain men could get there from the rear. With the aid of the Enfield rifles, they'd have a distinct advantage.
Mr. White.
Sir?
Orders for the guard commander. Effective immediately, this garrison is under martial law. No one, civilian or military, will leave without written permission.
Any good, sir?
Captain Rogers.
Sir?
In daylight hours, you'll take a detachment and move toward Peshawar. Make no attempt to cover your movements. You're on diversionary detail.
Right, sir.
Captain King.
Sir.
At nightfall, you in command of the Khyber Rifles will move to Jatra and attack. What is it, Mr. White?
Excuse me, sir. There's an Afridi outside. All I can understand is he wants to see Captain King.
Admit him. See what he wants.
Sir, the Khyber Rifles have refused to use the new Enfields. They believe they're contaminated.
Contaminated with what?
They've been told that the cartridges are greased with the fat from pigs. As you know, sir, to load the new Enfield, you have to bite the end off the cartridge. To an Afridi, this means tasting the flesh of a pig and committing an unpardonable sin.
Nonsense. An absurd idea made up to keep the natives from using the guns. Captain King?
Sir.
Assemble the men. I'll talk to them. Now, what is it, Captain King?
May I make a suggestion, sir?
Yes.
Mightn't it be better if I spoke to them?
Yes, Captain King. Please do.
Sir, the man who spread the rumor was Ishmael.
Ishmael?
Your Punkawala, sir.
The British have no wish to destroy your religion by unholy devices. There is no forbidden grease on the new cartridges. It will not defile your faith to use them. What you have heard is a lie, spread to weaken the forces that would defend India against tyrants. Sergeant Fowler.
Sir.
Rifle. Cartridge. You know the blood of India runs in my veins as it does in yours. I would no more degrade it than I would degrade the memory of my mother. If there is a man among you who will not follow me, let him step forward now and make himself known. Take up your rifles. Rifles, Obasa.
Quarter moon. Shouldn't be too bad.
No, sir. We can move in that.
Do you think they'll use the Enfields?
They have them, sir. But what goes on in their minds, only Allah knows.
You're doing a very courageous thing, Captain.
I'm only following my orders.
Good luck to you, Captain. Very good luck.
Dismount and leave our horses here. Sergeant, order dismount. From here we move by foot.
Why?
See that every rifle is loaded and primed.
Nay, sir.
Are all the rifles loaded?
Nay, sir. We have given it much thought. We have looked into ourselves and talked. We would like to follow you, sir. But what you believe to be the truth about the cartridges could be a lie.
Order them to load. Take up their rifles and load.
Better to die at your feet than to greet our love without a soul.
Then order them to retreat.
Nay, Captain Saab, we will not use the rifles, but we have blades of steel, and with this, we will follow you to the death.
Sentry?
Yes, sir.
Any show yet?
No, sir.
Commanding general is watching you. When I give the order, you will right about wheel. Do it smartly.
I've a rifle. My section, right about wheel.